Hi, Ben Constable with you from Sparx Systems. Today I'll demonstrate how to install and run Enterprise Architect in a non-Windows environment. My example being a Linux Mint desktop. But whether you use macOS or a different Linux distribution, the purpose of this webinar is to show you how to get up and running with Enterprise Architect quickly in your non-Windows environment using the Wine package. So the basic steps that we're going to walk through together today. First, you need to install the Wine package and some related components. Next, you need to download the Enterprise Architect installer. Then install EA via Wine. And finally, run Enterprise Architect just as you would in Windows. Later, I'll share some tips on enabling Unicode-aware model repositories, accessing shared DBMS models, and upgrading Enterprise Architect to newer versions. Our first step towards running Enterprise Architect on Linux or macOS is to download and install a suitable version of the Wine package. And for those wondering about Crossover, a commercial product based on Wine, that is also a viable option which we support. For this demo though, I'll use the free Wine package. You can install Wine in a couple of ways, either via your package manager or by running a specific install command. For the first approach, you'd invoke the package manager on Linux Mint like this. So look for the Wine package. Double-click that first result. And then just click to install it. Be aware though that the package manager can provide an older version of Wine. For example, here, I'd get Wine 1.6.2, which will work reasonably well, but we recommend running Wine version 1.9 or higher with Enterprise Architect 13. So I suggest running the install command yourself to get the latest development release of Wine. I've listed here the four commands you need to install the latest development version of Wine. I'll copy them from this notepad into a terminal and execute them one at a time. The first command is needed because I'm on a 64-bit system, so I have to enable the 32-bit architecture for Wine and its applications. Next, I add the Wine package repository to my package manager. Then I need to update the package lists. Now I tell the package manager to download and install the latest development version of Wine. So Wine is installed already, but there are some additional components needed. Firstly, WineTrix, which makes it easier to install libraries that EA requires. Then the Carlito font, which helps EA render text on diagrams exactly as it does in Windows. Finally, we use WineTrix to add support for XML and data handling libraries. Msxml 3 is first. By this point, you would have been prompted to download MSXML 3 from download.com and place it in your cache folder. For the sake of this demo, I've already done that. And just to show you where you need to move that file to once you've downloaded it, I'll just open a file browser here. So you see under .cache, MSXML 3. So next is MSXML 4. and finally MDAC. And that's it for the Wine installation and all of its components. Let's download and install EA now, and this part is exactly as you do in a Windows environment. In fact, the installation file is the same whether you're installing to Windows, Linux, or macOS. So first download your Enterprise Architect installer. If you're just trying out EA, grab it from our trial download page here. Of course, our registered users can download the full MSI file instead, but I'll stick with the trial edition for this demo. You click the download button here, which I've already done just to speed things up. Now open the MSI file you've downloaded and follow the prompts. So Enterprise Architect is installed and ready to go. Notice the entries in our Start menu under Wine here. We can open Enterprise Architect from there. And EA also appears on my Linux Mint desktop as well. Now let's run Enterprise Architect and create our first model. Just double-click the icon to open EA, just as you would on Windows. And I want to continue my trial of EA. The trial edition prompts me to select an Enterprise Architect edition. I'll use the default settings here. Just so you know, the Ultimate Edition includes just about everything in EA, including most of the add-in product extensions as well. Now, the first time you run the trial edition, you'll be prompted to choose a visual style with a screen like this one. And the visual style controls the theming and colors of EA's windows. You've got various options to choose from in the drop list here. And within each of those styles, you have various themes as well. Let's go for something a little more colorful. Okay. Now we're prompted to choose an existing project or create a new one here from this drop list. So let's create our first project. Click the drop list at the top, new project, and I'll name the project and just save it to my desktop for now. Next, EA offers to give me a kickstart to my model with various model patterns here. And we'll start with one of these patterns. Look, just a UML class model will do for this example. Say OK. And you'll see the model has been filled out for me in the project browser. And that's all based on the pattern that I just chose. So double-click to open one of those diagrams. And you might like to arrange your workspace to suit what you're doing. For example, I'm working with a fairly low screen resolution for the sake of this demo. So I can create some space by hiding a few of these windows here. And just customize my workspace using exactly the same approach I would under Windows. So hide the start bar there. We'll remove the properties and notes windows for now. Create a little more space on the left side. Well, that's just customizing the workspace. But we can create a basic model now, just for an example. I've got the same ribbons available to me as I have under Windows, the design menu here. Easily access the toolbar or just press spacebar to insert an element in place, like so. Create a new class, just for an example. Give it a name. And my class will do. I'll create a couple of connectors, just so you can see how that works. The quick link works just as it does under Windows. So create a little association here. Use a shift click as I'm routing the connector. Just do that as a go. Make an association connector. Tidy up the line style with an orthogonal square style. And similarly for the generalization as well. Just use the quick linker, add a generalization. Easy to do. So you get the idea. We're using EA just as we would under Windows, and as you can see, the performance is great as well. So now you've seen what's involved in setting up Enterprise Architect to run on a Linux or macOS desktop environment. The key steps? First, set up Wine, which allows you to run Windows-based software on Linux. We recommend getting a fairly recent development build of Wine for the best results. You also need to install WineTrix to help deploy those data handling components that EA uses. After that, the remaining setup is really no different to what you'd do on Windows. Download the Enterprise Architect installer, either the trial edition if you haven't purchased EA yet, or as a registered user, you can get the licensed edition by logging into our website. Then install EA as simply as running the installer and stepping through the prompts. Finally, as we saw today, when you run Enterprise Architect on Linux, your user experience is going to be virtually identical to what you'd expect within a Windows desktop environment, and much the same as regards performance. In future tutorials, we'll look at how to set up other products and features associated with EA on Linux or Mac, such as shared model repositories. But if you need more information in the meantime, please visit our EA Wine page, sparxsystems.com/wine. Well, that's it from me today. Till next time, happy modelling.